Wisconsin Democrats appear on the verge of doing something completely different next year, running a candidate for governor who's rich. Democrats in this state just don't do that, or at least they haven't. Think about the last 30 years. Tom Barrett, Jim Doyle, Ed Garvey, Chuck Quala, Tom Loftus, Tony Earle. Garvey was a labor attorney at the time he ran, but the rest came directly from the ranks of state and local government. Successful, yes. Rich, no. But if Madison School Board member Mary Burke gets into the race, that will change. Burke is part of the Trek bicycle family and could help fund what will surely be a very expensive race to unseat Governor Walker. Party leaders like Burke's business background. She was an executive with Trek, a former state commerce secretary. They like the way she's helped kids through her philanthropic efforts. But make no mistake about it, they like the fact she has money, perhaps more than some people think. They like that a lot. So Democrats, who see themselves as the champions of working families, may be prepared to bet the bank on a relatively untested candidate from the 1%, a candidate a former colleague recently described as so not a politician. May feel a bit uncomfortable to some Democrats who would like to see state lawmakers Kathleen Vineout or Peter Barca run against the governor. But a Burke candidacy just may represent a new reality in Wisconsin politics, one where unions have less financial clout, gubernatorial elections are all about job creation, and legislative records are a potential liability. Mary Burke may be the first deep pockets Democrat to run for governor in recent history, but she probably won't be the last. Thanks for being with us today. I'm Mike Gousha, and I'll see you again next week on Upfront.
You can see today's program on our website. Just click on the Upfront section of WISN.com.